Let's talk a little bit about analyzing your sizing results and how to determine if your data is valid. If you navigate to the Analyze page, you can see some of the sizing results that I've displayed here on some real samples. One tip for analyzing samples for the first time is to do a small concentration study. Especially if your sample is particularly cloudy in nature, it's a great idea to do a few dilutions of the sample to determine the proper concentration range for accurate results. For example, I started out with this milk sample, and if we navigate to the size window, you can see we get pretty decent results. You can look at the correlation function and the intensity distribution, which looks like a pretty good result. We even ran this triplicate to see if we get consistency across triplicate measurements, which in this case, it looks like a pretty good measurement. However, if you look to the record view, you can start to display a couple different values that may give you hints about the concentration range relative to the instrument. So some of the parameters that you may want to look at are the cuvette position, if you're doing a backscattering measurement, and the attenuator. So the attenuator has 11 different positions. For full laser power, you would have an attenuator of 11. And the lower the attenuator value, the lower the laser power that we are using for your sample. So for an attenuator of 3, this means that my sample is pretty concentrated, which we already knew because we could look at the sample and see that it's very cloudy in nature. Another indication is that the cuvette position is very close to zero. With non-invasive backscattering, we can change the focal position within your cuvette to avoid events such as multiple scattering. If you notice in this case that the cuvette position is very close to zero or close to the edge of the cuvette, you know that the instrument is trying to optimize and eliminate multiple scattering by pushing the position that it's measuring towards the edge of the cell. However, on some of these other samples, if you notice that we are measuring at 4.64, that's the center of the cell for the common disposable sizing cuvette. And so that would say the sample is quite dilute in nature. So this already gives me an indication that possibly my sample could be a little bit too concentrated to give me accurate sizing results. So I wanted to do a dilution just to see if I got the same result or if I got a different result. So now let's compare the first dilution versus the milk sample. We can now see we have a higher y-intercept value, and the y-intercept value gives you an indication for the signal to noise in your sample, which would say I have more signal at a lower concentration. That doesn't really make sense unless I was having some multiple scattering in the first run of the straight milk, and then by decreasing the concentration, I've now eliminated the multiple scattering, and now I have a much more accurate sizing result. Now let's just for fun do a couple more dilutions and see where things go. So let's display the dilution number 2. And at that dilution, now you can see we have the exact same sizing results. So now we can feel pretty confident that we're in the proper concentration range for getting good quality data for this sample. If you want to go even further, you can go further to another dilution and you see pretty similar results again. We feel pretty confident that we're in the correct concentration range for this sample. So I get this question a lot of what attenuator value or what cuvette position should I measure in to get the best results? And really, it just depends. As you can see, I could use dilution 1, 2, or 3, and those are very, very different concentration ranges. Either one of those concentrations will give me good sizing data. What you want to do is find that concentration range, which will be very broad, that will work well for your sample and stick with that and avoid the edges of too concentrated or too dilute. Now let's talk about something that's too dilute. So I just wanted to show an example of what it looks like if I just put a sample that doesn't really have any particles in it. In this case, I just took water and measured it. I get a result, but is the result really meaningful? Now, if I look over to the attenuator and I look over to the derived count rate here, we can see the derived count rate is very low. We can also see that the attenuator is 11, which means I'm using full laser power and I still don't get very much scattering from this sample. So it is very, very dilute. So in this case, probably what I'm measuring is a little bit of dust in the water of my sample.